Hi. Did you know that with Vista version 5.2 you will have a SpillZone available which is user definable dynamically during the show? So it's not a setting of the desk where you have to make up your position where the SpillZone is, but you can change it during the show wherever you want it. You can define, is it spilling from left to right, is it spilling from right to left, one bay, two bays, several, the full desk, whatever you want. This is a great feature for getting a temporary strip setup up on your desk's surface. So you have several sections and layers on your desk where your faders are placed. By just pressing contribution button of a bus, you bring all the members, the channels which are assigning to this bus, you bring that to the surface. Let's have a look at that. The spill zone is defined in the strip setup page. Open the strip setup, go to the spill zone tab, and there you can define where your spill zone is going to be. So you can select the left panel here, fader panel. Now it shows spill direction from left to right, so all the spilling channels will be ordered from left to right. You move it over here and you got it from right to left, also on the left panel. You can have more than one bay. Again, you see the direction of where the spill zone is going to be starting and ending, and you certainly also can take the whole desk from right to left or left to right, however you want. The only rule is the fader bays have to be next to each other, so you cannot define the outmost left panel and the outmost right panel, and in the middle you leave that open. So this wouldn't be possible. They have to be one after each other. Every type of group channel is able to spill out its assigned input channels. So you can spill out groups, masters, VMix buses, VCAs. Every type of group will be spilled out on the defined spill zone. Now, for example, let's take this master bus here, press contribute, and you see that all the channels are going to be laid out on the spill zone. The FaderGlow is turning red because the master code or the group code of this master is red. So it always shows you what type of group do you have spilled out on your zone. Now, since we only have one fader bay assigned as a spill zone, we don't have enough channels to represent them. So you now can scroll through your pages in the spill zone and see what is assigned to this channel, have full access, full channel access, processing everything is reachable from here. So you see also that the arrow key here is showing you there's more on the right. Now it's showing you there's more on the left and the right, and when you get to the end to the spill zone, it shows you there's only the possibility to go left. Right? We also see here that we have a group assigned to this master channel. Now we can go a step lower, what we call nested spill, and you can spill out this group. Now we have all the channels of this group lined out on your spill zone. You can jump out directly here from your group, get a step higher again, or go all out with one click out of the master, and you get the regular desk set up again the way you laid it out for your show. So the great thing of this feature is it always brings you stuff wherever it is placed on the desk, or even if it's not placed, if it's a channel in the background which is processing, if you spill it out, you got it on the desk. You don't have to go to the strip setup and get your channels onto the surface to do a change. This feature is great if you run different shows on one desk. So you can always go to the master and get all your contributing channels onto the surface, change whatever you want, make adjustments, go to the next master where you're actually running a next stage in a live event, for example, and stuff like that. It's also great for speaker management, where you use your auxiliaries, spill them out, and you get all the sources which go to the speaker, adjust them, and you're ready and set. Well, that was it for today. Thank you for watching, and hope to see you soon again.